nobody's buying 1969 Chevs anymore. I can show you some numbers that'll compare a 1983 car and a 2013 car. The 2013 car, it gets 50% better fuel economy, and it has a whole range of new features that weren't even dreamed of in 1983. Modern cars are really tremendous, but that's not good enough. New fuel economy regulations are coming in now, which are going to literally force manufacturers to make double the fuel economy, and that is what's driving the projects now. It's essential that people be willing to try new things, and that doesn't matter whether they're a person working in a factory on an assembly line, or whether they're an R&D engineer or a senior executive of a company. The old ways of doing things are not going to work anymore.
So the workforce that used to build the things in these manufacturing plants is now shifting towards a bit more of a skilled workforce that's managing a plant that's essentially automated.
My name is Pete Carvalho. I'm the shop leader or shop foreman. I'm in charge of all the integration that comes from upstairs from design, the electrical and mechanical engineering. But I look at all the tasks that are coming from engineering down to the shop floor and the full integration of the automation or whichever component it is that we've sold to our customers. We're looking for individuals who are multitaskers, that they can machine, they can build at a very high level, but in the same token, they understand the pneumatics, have a good understanding of the electrical systems. That in turn keeps us ahead.
You want to choose the correct program for yourself and what you're interested in. Because if you have a direct interest somewhere, that's where you're going to excel in.
For me, personally, I'm a bit of a geek, is to actually have my hands on all this technology that not all companies are willing to get into, because sometimes it's a little complex, sometimes it's more of a learning curve than some want to invest in it, and to be able to play and basically learn new things every day.
I think that's really where the automotive industry in Canada is going, is the developing of the new technologies, being more innovative, finding the new ways of doing things and making automobiles better than they are right now.
So 3D printing is definitely a new technology to manufacturing industries. If you need to do something like prototype a part just to see if it's the part that you want or something like that, making an injection mold, for example, for that is just prohibitively expensive. So 3D printing is a technology that allows you to do this at low volumes. It allows you to print just one part or a few parts at a very low cost. But in the future, we're looking at 3D printers that are actually going to be manufacturing real parts with composite materials.
It's all about lightweighting. Vehicle lightweighting is the new thing. We know that for 10% of every vehicle weight down, we get a 7% spike in fuel efficiency. So the mandate coming out of the US government is something like 54 miles per gallon for every vehicle on the road for the year 2025. How do we do that? We have to create lighter parts with different materials, and composites really lead the way when it comes to that.
So things are changing very rapidly now. That's why you're seeing, pickup trucks with aluminum bodies, hybrid electric vehicles, more diesel vehicles. You're seeing, battery electric vehicles.
Electric vehicle technology, it's not a new idea. It is the best new old idea, actually. We need electric vehicles that can go far. We need electric vehicles that will cost less. We need electric vehicles that can be charged really quickly. Then you will see that people are buying them. We all need to sit down, make plans so that we can advance this technology.
The other one that you hear is that, oh, manufacturing, it's dirty, it's low tech, it's backbreaking work. You know, there are some pretty challenging jobs in every manufacturing facility, but for the most part, it's not dirty at all. It's not low tech. These are highly automated, very advanced technology facilities. They're clean, they're safe, they're interesting. There's always change, there's always a new challenge, always something to work on.
A common misconception that the broader community might have about the auto industry is that it's a big, large, dirty, polluting industry. Some of the emissions, what comes out of the tailpipe of these vehicles, can be cleaner than the air that you're breathing in a particular city. They're that efficient these days.
The products that this industry make, are they the sort of things that people are going to want in the future? What does a car do? Well, it allows an individual or a small group of people to go where they want to go at a given time. Is that something people are going to want to do in the future? Well, I think so.
We probably have the number one industry when it comes to tool and die and tool and mold. Without a doubt, we have the most highly skilled workforce probably in the world. And we have a lot of our students that are feeding that industry and learning from those that have pioneered it 20, 30 years ago.
These are all things that people treasure now and will treasure in the future, will value in the future. And that means that the need for automotive products is going to continue. In fact, I think it's going to accelerate.